Hello friends, welcome back to Tech Greens. So today in this video we'll take up Hadoop scenario based interview questions. So in this particular video we'll take up a question that how we can predict the cluster or the hardware size for the Hadoop cluster, what are the different considerations that we need to do, and what is the way to calculate and predict the future size of the Hadoop cluster. This is a question primarily meant for Hadoop admins, but at the same time, as a Hadoop developer also, you need to have an understanding that how the entire hardware Hadoop cluster is set up and what are the different considerations that needs to be taken care of while designing a cluster. So guys, let's start. Yeah. So the scenario that we have here, we are trying to estimate the number of data nodes based on the current data size and what is the increase pattern in the data coming into the system. So guys, as we know, estimation of the hardware requirement is always a challenging thing, especially in the Hadoop environment, because we never know when data demand or storage demands will go higher, what is the business trend, what is the trend of data spike. Understanding of the following factors in detail will help us to solve a current scenario at hand to find the right size of the Hadoop cluster in terms of hardware, specifically to find out the number of data nodes required for these data size given. So scenario that we have currently is that we have a 8 TB disk available per node, and we have around 10 disks per node with the 1 TB size. Two disks are already excluded for operating system, system logs and other daemons, and intermediate input outputs and all those things. So assuming that initial data size that we have is 600 TB, we will have to estimate the number of data nodes. And also we are given with the data increase pattern of say 20% over the year. So the scenario, I hope, is clear that the scenario we are trying to solve today is that we have a 8 TB disk size available, you know, or we have 10 disks of 1 TB each, and we have initial data set of 600 TB. We are trying to find out the number of disks or we can say required for the different data nodes, or in simple, what would be the number of data nodes in this Hadoop cluster. So couple of points to be considered before we start the actual calculation. First thing is obviously the actual data size, initial data size, which is 600 TB. What would be the data trending analysis? What would be the data increase pattern or prediction? Whether it is based on days, week, quarter, year, etc. This parameter is required. Then we'll take into effect replication factor. Default is 3. The amount of logs, you know, hardware machine overheads, operating systems, number of different daemon processes. So we have considered 2 disks for that. As we had 10 disks of 1 TB each, we are only considering 8 TB. Then disk input output, the intermediate mapper and reducer data also goes on to the hard disk, though it doesn't go into the Hdfs, but 1x data storage would be considered here. The storage capacity of the underlying disk, obviously we would not prefer that our disk go for 100% utilization. We'll see that there should be maximum utilized 60 to 70%. And then we'll take into account the compression ratio. Whatever the compression algorithm used, what would be the compression ratio that we'll take into account to calculate the actual sizing of the data. So these are a couple of the points that we'll keep in mind to do the calculations for the number of data nodes would be required in this Hadoop cluster. So let's start with the calculation. So the data size is 600 TB. Replication factor 3, intermediate data out of mapper and reducer 1x. So according to this, the total storage requirement would be 3 plus 1 into 600 TB. That means the total storage requirement would be 2400 TB. Now the available disk size that we have considered is 8 TB for one disk. So the total number of required data nodes, or total number required, data nodes would be 2400 divided by 8. So this gives us a rough or a base calculation of 300 machines that will need 300 data nodes. But the actual calculation will take two more parameters into account. What would be the disk utilization? As we have discussed initially, we'll prefer to keep it between 60 to 70%, and we'll also take into account the compression ratio. So let's try to do the actual calculation. Let's see that this calculation, we have taken the mean of 60 and 70, which is 65%, and we have considered compression ratio as 2.3%. Then the total storage requirement, because the data would be compressed by the ratio of 2.3, so total storage requirement would go down. We'll divide 2400 by 2.3, so we get 1043.5 TB as the storage requirement. Available disk for storage, we consider 8 TB, but we said we'll only take into account 65% of this utilization. So that means we would have, on one machine, we would have 5.2 TB of data available. So that means total number of machines, data nodes required would be 1043.5 TB divided by 5.2 TB. So now we have got the approx number of data nodes machines would be 201. By rough calculation on previous slide, we get 300 machines. Now adding the replication factor and disk utilization, we got around 201 machines. So 201 machines means that the actual usable cluster size in terms of memory, cluster size would be number of machines, 8 TB disk size into compression ratio, right? And we'll divide it by 4, right, which will give us the total usable cluster size, which comes out around 925 TB, right? Correct. By 4 we have done is like 3 for replication factor, 1x for the intermediate data. So this will give the actual usable cluster size, right? We'll all obviously store it 4 times, but the actual usable cluster size would be 925 TB. So here we have added a business case that we have predicted that there would be a 20% data increase in a quarter. So we need to predict that how we'll have to grow the number of machines or data nodes every quarter. So let's see the calculations, right? So in one quarter, we had this much of data storage required in TBs. So we have 20% increase in first quarter, we'll do into 0.2, which gives us this number. Similarly, in next quarter we do 1.2 into 2, and in third quarter we have again 1.2 into 1.2 into 0.2. similarly, 1.2 into 1.2 into 1.2 into 0.2 for fourth quarter. This is how every time we are increasing it by 20% by in every quarter. And we have the available disk size for storage, considering the utilization ratio of 65 is 5.2 TB. So in first quarter, we will need 41 machines, right? Based on a 21% increase. Then in next quarter, we'll need 49 machines. So that means between first quarter and second quarter, we need 8 more machines. Second and third quarter, we need 9 more machines. And between third quarter and fourth quarter, we need 12 more machines. So in an over a year, we need 29 additional data nodes or machines to handle the data increase of 20% over a quarter. So based on these calculations, we can say that for every year on this kind of a trend, we said the number of data machines or data nodes needs to grow, say, number of machines in last quarter plus 29, and similarly we'll calculate further for the future year. So this is how we can do calculation to say that, you know, this would be the number of data nodes in our Hadoop cluster, and with a 20% increase over quarter, we need to add 29 additional data nodes in 1 year. So guys, this is one technique to estimate the cluster size in the Hadoop world. Thanks for watching. Keep learning. Have a good day. Bye-bye.